viewers, in this session we are going to tell about overview of deep learning. Before going to the concept of deep learning, let us see one example. This example says about the handwritten digit recognition. Here I have given 2 as an input as a digit, and this input will go to the machine, and how the machine learns with many algorithms, that is the performance of the machine, and after that the machine will learn that it is a number 2. How it does? Now first of all, the digit 2 will be digitized into number of pixels. Here I have taken that 16 rows and 16 columns. Therefore 16 by 16, that is equal to 256 pixels will be there. And here I have divided that if there is an ink, that is your black color, then the input will be 1, and if it is no ink, that is white color, then input will be 0. Now each and every pixel will be input to the each and every input, that is your x1 to x256. Now for example, in x1 it will be 0, in x2 it will be 0, and for x3 it will be 1, and like this. This is the input layer, and in the output side we will have the 10 digits, that is from 0 to 9. Here in this case, each and every output we will get the confidence level or the strength level. Since it is a number 2, so in the second output we will get the maximum strength, and therefore the machine will learn that it is number 2 and it will recognize the digit as number 2. So in this case, what is happening, that means the input, that is 256 inputs, are mapped with 10 outputs, right? And the mapping is done with the help of the algorithm. In the previous module, you must have learned about various machine learning algorithms. In case of deep learning, this function F, what I have shown here, is represented by a neural network. So we can say that deep learning is a subset of machine learning. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. Now, what is the definition or the concept of artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence says that it is the effort to automate intellectual tasks normally performed by humans. Now, what is the purpose of developing this machine learning? Machine learning arises from the question that could a computer do beyond what a human being knows how to order to perform it and learn on its own how to perform a work? Yes, that is actually machine learning. So, if we want to know the definition of machine learning, we can say that it is a branch of the field artificial intelligence which aims to create intelligent systems which can do human-like jobs by learning from a large amount of relevant data. This is the catch here, because in machine learning you have to give input of large amount of data. So to compare with the classical programming, we can say that in case of classical programming, what we give the input? We give the input as rules as well as data, and we get the output as the answers. But in case of machine learning, we give the input as data as well as the answers itself, because it is the target or the estimated output that you want to give to the machine. Machine will learn by training these data again and again, again and again, and finally it will register as some specific rule. And when you will give input after that, when you will give input any data, any new data, then the machine will learn with that specific rule that what is the data it has to recognize. Now, what are the different examples of machine learning? First example, we can say that what we see daily in our life, that is your Apple Siri. We say that Siri, what is the time, and you get the answer. Similarly, we can say that Amazon Alexa, it also does many duties according to our requirement. Similarly, Microsoft Cortana, Google Translator, it translates For example, here I have written that if you are writing that I am working at night at Chandigarh, then automatically it will be translated in Hindi or in other languages, right? Self-driving car, this is also an example of machine learning. Recommended apps, this is also an example of machine learning, where it will recommend when you are going to download any app, it will recommend you that whether the app is free of malware or not. You are safe to download that app or not, right? Then again, another application is your sentiment analysis. This we see when we are going for, you know, voting before the election or some before any match. The persons, various people actually, they give various comments, various tweets in a Twitter, and all these tweets we can analyze and we can take that what is the sentiment of the common people. Another application is that is your fraud detection. Now, in case of deep learning compared to machine learning, as I have said, that deep learning always takes neural network as a backend, right? So here we get the input layer, that is your first layer, and also the output layer, right? And in between this input layer and output layer, there are many hidden layers. It may be 10 to 50 or it may range to 100 to 150, right? Depending on the number of layers, your accuracy will be increased. So in deep learning, there are two terms. One is your deep, another is your learning. Deep word in deep learning stands for the successive layers of representation. In normal neural network, you basically use only 2 to 3 layers, but in case of deep learning, we use 100 to 150 layers, right? So the deep word we have come to know, that deep means that how many depth of the layers. What do you mean by learning? Learning definition has been given by many scientists. Herbert Simon, he has said that learning denotes changes in a system that enable a system to do the same task more efficiently the next time. Michael Ski has given the definition of learning as learning is constructing or modifying the representations of what is being experienced. Minsky, another scientist, he has given that learning is making useful changes in our minds. In simple language, if we want to say that what is learning, we can say in the two terms. First one is the acquisition of knowledge, the process of acquiring the knowledge, right? It can be defined as the acquisition of knowledge or skills through study, experience, or being taught, right? Or in the other sense, we can say that knowledge acquired through study, experience, or being taught. That means the process is also learning. When you have got the knowledge, that is also learning, right? Now, in neural network, what is the architecture of a learning element? In common language also, if we say the learning element, then how it learns? It learns with experience, it learns with feedback, right? In neural network also, the learning element learns with its performance and with the critic. Critic means the feedback from where it is getting feedback from outside, and performance, that means what it is giving the output. Again, the output will be checked with the target output. If it is not equal, then the error will be sent, feedback will be sent to the learning element. Again, it will modify itself, it will update itself, and finally, it will give the performance again. So this process is known as your training, right? Now, in deep learning, if we want to define deep learning, we can say that most deep learning methods use neural network architectures. That is why deep learning models are often referred to as the deep neural network. As I have told earlier, that in normal neural network, we use 1 to 2 or 2 to 3 hidden layers. But in case of deep learning, we use 100 to 150 hidden layers. The maximum you use the hidden layers, the maximum accuracy you will obtain, right? Deep learning models are trained by using the large set of labeled data. and neural network architectures that learn features directly from the data without the need for manual feature extraction. Here is the difference between the machine learning and the deep learning. In case of machine learning, we input the features, right? But in case of deep learning, we input the image itself. In the figure itself, you can get the differences. When we are giving input as a car, the person is extracting the features from car. For example, wheels, steering, and another features of car, right? And all these features will be sent to the learning algorithm. That may be any algorithm. What you have learnt in the last module is maybe the SVM, it may be the naive-Bayes algorithm, it may be the logistic regression algorithm, any algorithm, right? When you are sending the features to the machine learning algorithm, and finally the output, it will recognize that it is a car. But in case of deep learning, that we will input only the image of a car, and it is the duty of deep learning algorithm to extract the features and also to classify, and the final output it will show you as a car. So if I say the difference between the machine learning and deep learning, so first point I have given, that is your data dependencies. In case of machine learning, it is giving the excellent performance on a small or medium data set. But in case of deep learning, excellent performance on a big data set. So here is the catch, that when you have only the small amount of data, better to go for machine learning. And if you have the big data set, then you go for the deep learning. Hardware dependencies work in machine learning, it works on a low end machine, right? Simple CPU will be quite enough to calculate this algorithm. But in case of deep learning, it requires powerful machine, for example, GPUs, general purpose unit processor it requires. The third point I have given, that is a feature engineering. As I have told before, that in case of machine learning, it needs to understand the different features, right? Manually we have to extract the features. But in case of deep learning, it is no need to understand the best feature because it does itself. Now come to the execution time. In case of machine learning, it takes only few minutes to hours, but in case of deep learning, it takes up to weeks, depends on your GPUs, right? How much strength your processor has. And in interoperability, some algorithms are easy to interpret because in case of machine learning, but in deep learning, interoperability is not so much easy. It turns from difficult to impossible. Now, when to use ML or when to use DL, that is deep learning and machine learning. If your training data set is small, then you use the machine learning. If your data set is large, then you use deep learning. And if you want to choose your features, then you go for machine learning. If you don't want to choose your features, then you go for deep learning. And if you have, if you want many choice, if you want the choice of many algorithms, you go for machine learning. But in case of deep learning, the choice is less, right? Training time is short in case of machine learning, but training time is large in case of deep learning. Advantage is that in case of deep learning, you get the much accuracy and you don't have to extract the features. Directly you can send the images to the deep learning. So what are the applications of deep learning? We can get the application of deep learning in image classification, speech recognition, also the handwriting transcription, in machine translation, right? And also it is used for text to speech conversion, and sometimes web searching method also we can use the deep learning. And finally, since this course is your big data analytics with smart grid, so here I will give the demo of smart grid data analysis with the help of deep learning. So in this session, just I have described about the concept of machine learning, deep learning, the differences of machine learning and deep learning, when to use machine learning and when to use deep learning, as well as the applications of machine learning and deep learning. Thank you.